1940. Hitler's ruthless quest to extend Germany's borders has his people at war with the world. The mobilization of armies by Britain and France proves no deterrent as the Nazis invade their European neighbors to the north and west, while extending their reach eastward towards Russia's critical oil fields. By fall, Germany's lightning war to soften England is launched, and America increases production, racing to aid the British. By 1941, the battle for North Africa is on as Rommel's Africa Corps arrives in Tripoli. On the Eastern Front, an impatient Hitler breaks his pact with the Soviets. Stalin responds with a scorched earth policy, intent on leaving only ruins for the Nazi invaders. But one by one, his cities fall. Now, in 1942, massive German air raids commence against Stalingrad, and the battle for this noble city turns vicious. The Red Army refuses to retreat, and a counteroffensive is launched against the force that now stretches from the Volga to the Atlantic and deep into the African desert. Against impossible odds, millions come forward to answer the call of their countries, their families, their lives.
My name is Alexander Sokolov. I thought I was safe. As a watchmaker's apprentice, I would learn the business, then open a shop of my own. Maybe get married, have children, start a life. But now our cities are under attack, and Stalingrad will put an end to those dreams. We should have known the Germans would turn on us, break the treaty. They have no honor. The commissars rounded us up so quickly, speaking of the motherland, the sacrifices of our brothers, our duty. I'm only 20, but I'm ready to fight to the death. The sight of my home Stalingrad infuriates me. It is as if hell itself were burning.
Welcome to Stalingrad. You're about to begin the greatest moment of your life. The Germans have lost hundreds of tanks and planes. Hitler's brutalized hordes are now advancing towards Stalingrad over mountains of their own dead bodies. Our Bolshevik party, our nation, our great country have given us the task not to let the enemy reach the Volga and to defend the city of Stalingrad. Against the enemy, up into the unremitting battle, comrades! For Stalingrad, for our great country, not one step back! Cowards and traitors will be shot! Do not count days, do not count miles, count only the number of Germans you have killed! Kill the German, this is your mother's prayer! Kill the German, this is the cry of your Russian earth! Do not waver! Do not let up! Kill! Death to the German invader!
And follow my orders. I will shoot you myself. Come quickly. We're expected at the front lines. The fascists have reached the park and are about to cut Stalingrad in half. We must stop them at all costs. They've stopped shelling the boats. Be ready for anything. If you hear the incoming whistle of the artillery, the explosion will not be far off. down!
Incoming fire! Move! Get down! Incoming fire!
Go! Quickly!
Here in the refinery. We need to flush them out before we get to the park. Follow my lead. Wait here!
Die, Nazi devil!
You, over here! Pick up his rifle!
Take it, G!
Trouble.
Explosive! Stand back!
Fire, fire, fire.
This way, comrades!
Hide that! Let's go!
Forward, comrades!
Comrade, I'm impressed. Follow me.
Mommy, coordinates is just ahead. But first, we need to flush the Germans out of this building. Give us the signal to go. I'll cover you!
All day. I'm sorry you lost your sergeant, Comrade. We won't let his sacrifice go to waste. I've got a new job for you. The fascists are using the view from that bunker to call in artillery strikes all over the city. We can't take back Stalingrad unless we control that bunker. You lead the men up the hill. Start by taking out the machine guns in those pillboxes. Stick to the trenches. I'll keep you covered from here. That Nazi flag must fall.
We'll be right back.
My name is Tanya Pavlovna. We had little idea the Nazi invasion had pushed as far as our village until the night we awoke to the sound of tank tracks grinding in the distance. Tank shells sent my neighbor scurrying for cover. And in the chaos, I was separated from my parents. The next day, I was rescued by soldiers with the Red Army. I was 25. During my first skirmish, our squad was cut down, and I escaped into a collapsed building, where I took a sniper rifle off the body of a fallen comrade. My father's voice guided my aim as I cut down my first four Germans with that rifle. My skill was reported to HQ, and I was assigned as a sniper and sent to Stalingrad. I've been hunting Germans ever since. They took my family and my home, and I intend to take their lives.
You've got a clear shot. What are you waiting for?
An explosion. We need something to cover the sound of the rifle. And if I shoot enough of these Germans, they'll send a tank to come looking for us. Then we'll need to cover our sapper on the street so he can place a landmine in its path. This is it. Always try to shoot the officers first. Let's relocate.
Here's a good vantage point.
Thank you.
survive, we must work together. To get through.
Thank you.
trench to the factory should be around here somewhere.
Climb down the ladder. The factory is just past this hole in the wall. Anya, hurry! The tractor factory is just ahead. Incoming mortars! Keep your head down! Thank you. There's another group of gunners! Panzer shreds coming from the right! More panzer shreds to the right! Machine gun on the right! 4, get back from the window!
My name is Nikolai Badenov. The day after the Germans attacked the Soviet Union, I left my wife and newborn son in the care of my parents and joined the Red Army. Having been a mechanic in Leningrad for years, it was no surprise I was assigned to the 24th Tank Corps. I live for the day we grind Berlin beneath our tracks. Perhaps it's this aggressiveness that won me my own tank crew and assignment in Stalingrad. While my crew and I are like family, there's another comrade who I'll be tied to forever. Her name is Tanya Pavlovna, and she saved our skins as we escaped in the last surviving T-34 after an assault on an old factory near Volgograd. But our tank soon had engine trouble, and the smoke plume was giving away our position. So we found what looked to be a safe place to make repairs.
Engine trouble?
Tanya, you and Alexander find some high ground and watch for the enemy.
We'll do what we can, Nikolai.
And Fyodor, let's get that tank fixed now.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Lieutenant, follow me. Watch, sorry. General Belov, sir. Tank Commander Lieutenant Nikolai Badenov to see you.
Lieutenant, the situation is grave. We've been holding back the German advance with the Katyusha rockets. However, our forward observer's radio has stopped working, and we are no longer receiving firing coordinates. Their last report said the fascists were massing armor and preparing to overrun this headquarters. The observers are in the train station tower on the other side of Red Square. Take a replacement radio and get it over to that tower before the Germans make their next move. Dismissed.
Make way. Wounded soldier coming. Good. Set it down here. Hey, Lieutenant, look who we found!
Glad to see you made it, Nikolai. That tank destroyer nearly buried us alive.
You better go, Lieutenant. We'll take care of her.
Good luck, Kamil.
The tank is ready! Let's go!
We'll be right back. way with the tank.
Is this the new radio? Good. The observers are in the tower, but this place is crawling with Germans. We'll have to fight our way through, room by room. On your signal.
Whatever you need. Observation post on the other side. Good luck.
German armor's about to move. We need to relay firing coordinates now. New target, fire point Bravo. Angle 78 degrees, range 100 meters. Confirm, over.
Confirm. Range 100 meters.
One hell of a day.
December 24, 1942, Christmas Eve. What we began at Stalingrad, we were to finish as part of Operation Little Saturn. On a remote airfield near the small village of Tatsinskaya. Our assignment was to approach the airfield from the north via the River Don, cutting off and encircling the stranded German forces Hitler had forbidden to retreat. There at Tatsinskaya, we would surprise the airfield, destroying as many aircraft as we could, cutting off the resupplying of Nazis in the Stalingrad pocket. This was an assignment I was going to enjoy. But as we were about to spring our attack, the Germans got word we were there and launched a frantic evacuation. We may have missed yelling surprise, but there was still plenty of party to be had.
Your orders are to take control of the enemy airfield near Tatsinskaya to prevent them from resupplying the 6th Army at Stalingrad. This is a critical mission, comrades. Best of luck.
Raven, this is platoon leader. What is your status, over?
patrol leader, we're Raven here. Our trucks are in position. We need 10 minutes to set up the rockets. Over.
Hold positions until... Suka! Stuka! Incoming! We have been spotted! Raven, we cannot wait! Get your rockets in position now! We will take care of those bombers!
We're pinned down by an anti-tank crew. We can't get through to the airfield until somebody takes them out.
From the vehicle, dismount.
This building is crawling with Germans. We need to clear it out.
Soviets have barricaded themselves inside the control tower.
Thank you.
gather some intelligence for headquarters.
Look, this will certainly make some heads turn. Let's get back to headquarters.
Nice bonfire you lit up today, comrades. That should keep us warm most of the winter.